Today I'm going to teach you how to create a CMS with Framer. If you've watched my previous video on how to create a very quick design portfolio with Figma and Framer, this is the perfect video to pick it up. And if you want to expand on that video, I would stay tuned until the end because I have huge news for you. But first things first, what is a CMS? A CMS, or a content management system, is a way to dynamically manage the content on your site, which in very simple terms, it means that you create it or you design it once and you reuse it as many times as you want, but with different information and different content. And in our case, we are going to use it for our projects. Now, let's think about a CMS in very abstract terms. Let's imagine each one of our projects is a block of information. Each block of information has different data. It has a project title, it has a type, it has a client, it has a year, and it can have as many fields as we want. Each project, each block, will have different information, but they will all share the same fields or the same structure. And this is what makes it so clever. We can create this structure and reuse it for as many projects as we want with the same design and the same layout. So it's quick, efficient, and you only need to create it once. And we are going to keep things fairly simple so you understand the basics of it and take it from there. So let's jump into Framer so I can show you how it works. Now, I have a very simple design for my portfolio on Framer with only 3 pages. I have a home here with some data, I have the about page, and then I have some projects. Now, none of these has any data, and that's fine. And also, I've designed the desktop and the mobile version, but if you only have the desktop, that's absolutely fine. It will work the same way. Now, adding a CMS in Framer, it is extremely easy. The only thing you need to do is go here at the top, click on CMS, and click the plus button. And this has created your first CMS collection. Now I'm going to rename it Projects because I want this CMS to manage the different projects on my portfolio site. If you notice, we only have a couple of fields here. We only have the title and we only have the Slack. Now a title would be maybe our project title, and Slack is whatever goes after the backslash on the URL. So maybe you have yourname.com/projects/whatever. So that whatever, that's the Slack. So for each project, that will be different. So we only have 2 fields, but we can have as many as we want. And because we are talking about design projects, we might already know which ones we are going to use for sure. So in order to edit the fields that we want, we're going to go here and say edit fields. And this will open the projects field. We know the title, so I'm going to rename it project title. I'm going to create a bit of plain text, so something that I can quickly write, and I'm going to call it client. I'm going to create another one, which will be plain text again for the year. And for the project type, instead of saying plain text, I'm going to say option. This way I have like a multi-select and I can select like different options. So I'm going to say project type. And on option one, I'm going to say web design, AR experience, game design. And I'm going to create another plain text that will be my role, so my role on the project. And notice that as we add a new field to it, this gets added here at the top. And that is exactly what we want. For now, I'm going to keep it like this, but know that you can add as many fields as you want and you can play around with these different formats. So maybe you want to add images to the different projects, maybe you want to have a color per each project or per each project type. Play around with the different fields because you can do so much more. So cool, we have these fields here, but we don't really have any content. Like if we were to go back to our design, we wouldn't see any change there because we need to add content to it. And in order to do that, we need to hit here, new item. And this will open the part of the CMS that we can actually edit. So here we can write the name of our project, we can write the client, etc. So I'm going to write down a few projects that are completely fake, but would be great to work on, just so we can see them on our website. So I've created 5 projects here with a variety of clients, years, and project types, so we can see how everything changes on our design. So let's go back to our website design and notice that nothing has changed. Like literally nothing has changed. We've added the CMS, but our design is still the same because now we need to connect our CMS to our design, and Framer gives us 2 ways to do this. We can either do this as a collection list or we can do it with a project page. Now, a collection list is all the items of our CMS in one place. So imagine a list of all the projects that we have on our collection in just one place, which literally is what we need for our homepage. And a project page is an individual page for each one of our projects. And this is exactly what we need for our project pages here. So one page per project. Let's start with the collection list. Now, in order to add a collection list to our homepage, we need to go to Insert here, scroll down to where it says CMS, Collection List, and let's drag this to our side. And for now, we're going to drag it here. And notice how Framer has taken all the data of our CMS and put it in the page. We have our project title, we have the client, the year, we have the role in it. So all the information is there, but obviously it's not the correct design that we want. So how do we turn this data into our design? Now we have two options here. We can either take this list and redesign it so it looks like this section here, or we can use this section here and connect it to the data to our CMS. So because I already have my design here and I know how I want it to look like, I'm going to connect this project title to the different project titles that I have on my CMS, the same with the project type and the same with the year. So I make sure that the design stays consistent. So the way to do this is, first of all, I'm going to go to layers and I'm going to check this collection list and I'm going to remove everything that's inside it because I don't want this to look like this. So I'm just going to delete it. And now we have this collection list missing a child layer. So in order to connect our design to our collection, we need to connect them. So I'm going to take the project link here and I'm going to drag it inside the collection link. So because now our project link is inside the collection list, we can use the information that we have on our CMS. But we're running into a problem now. Something has happened. It has created 5 instances which represent the 5 projects that we have on our CMS. But it's not taking the data that we want. It's not showing our correct project titles or the project type. It's not showing anything. So what's going on? The problem here now is that, okay, we have this project here, but we haven't told Framer that we want this text here to be our project title. It says that, but it could say ABC and it could be the same. We are not telling the system that we want this specific text to be connected to our project title. So how do we do that? Very easy. We are going to go back to project title so it makes more sense. And I'm going to make sure I'm selecting project title. I'm going to go to the text properties. And next to content, you can see this plus button here. I'm going to click it and say set variable project title. And what this is doing is creating a variable. So it means that this bit of text will change per each project. And what I'm setting it to is the project title that we have to our CMS. So as soon as I say project title, this will change to the project titles that I have on my CMS. And this is perfect. So we are going to do the same with the year, selecting year, going to text properties, content, and year. Perfect. And I'm going to do the same with the project type. And this is slightly different because remember we set the project type to be an option selector. So it will be down here and we will have to say display option. And this is now showing the correct titles, the correct project types, and the correct years. Now the next thing we need to do is to create a specific page for each one of these projects. And we're going to do that by going here where it says pages, going to the CMS option, hitting plus, and saying detail page. Now this has created 5 different pages because those are the projects that we have on our CMS. Now the design doesn't look exactly what we want it to be, but we now have 5 dynamic pages that we can edit for each one of our projects. And one good thing about this is that you only need to create it once, like design it once, and it will replicate for each one of our projects. So because we already have a project page that we've designed, this will be very easy. I'm going to go back to these project pages and I'm going to make sure I remove everything that is inside. I'm going to go back to the design that I have and select everything here. And I'm going to copy it. Perfect. And just to make sure that it's working for each one of our pages, we are now on the Nickelodeon project, but it's working for each one of them. Now, obviously we have an issue now, that is that it's not showing anything. But that has a very easy solution. So as we've done on the homepage, we can select a bit of text and connect it to our CMS. So I'm going to scroll to the text properties, hit content, set variable, and connect it to the project title. And the same with my year. And now when I change the page, everything is updated with the correct information, which is perfect. So let's finish connecting this. The client and the project type. And now for each one of our projects, everything is updated correctly. So because we now have these dynamic pages, we can get rid of this page here, can delete it. And I'm going to quickly create the mobile breakpoint for the project pages. That's looking good enough for me. Good. And I've done this really quickly, but if you are interested on how responsive design works on Framer, let me know below so I can prepare a video about it. But cool. So there's one last thing we need to do, and that is connecting the different projects on our project list here on the homepage to each specific page. Because now when we preview this site, these are not actually linked. So these, I'm clicking here and nothing is happening. So the way to do this is very easy. We're going to go to layers and make sure that we are selecting our project link here because we want the whole thing to be a link to the page. And remember when I was telling you earlier what a slug is, what was defined on our CMS, which is the part that goes after the backslash. So that is what it's going to define to which page each link goes. So I'm going to select the project link. I'm going to go here to link. And I'm going to say easily project/Slug. And that is everything you need to do. Now, each one of these pages, if we preview it, will link to each specific project page. And that is perfect. That is exactly what we need. Now, creating websites this way is very quick and easy because you literally design it once and you create as much content as you want. So we can quickly test it by going to our CMS and adding a new project. So I'm going to say Fujifilm website, just some random project. I'm going to save it. And when I go back to my design, this will have added a new link that when I test it and I click on it, it will take me to its own page. And that's all I did. I have only added a new item to my CMS, and this has dynamically created a new project link to my homepage and a new project page. So this is pretty much it. We've created a collection list for our homepage. We've created a specific project page for each one of our projects, and we've linked this collection list to each specific project. Now you can spend so much time editing your CMS, like things that you could add to improve it could be to add a field for a description, to add images so these ones are updated as well. You could even add videos, you can add more content, but I think for now, this is where we are going to stop. So you know the basics of the CMS and you feel confident to tackle any projects that you want.
And this is pretty much it. I hope now the Framer CMS looks less intimidating to you and you are able to use it for your own projects. But if you are still not comfortable with it, I've left a link in the description so you can duplicate the same project that I've been using for this video so you can use it for your own portfolio. However, if you want to dive deeper and you want to create your first design portfolio using Figma and Framer, I've just launched my new Skillshare class fully dedicated to it. And to celebrate it, I'm giving away one free month of Skillshare so you can watch not only this class but so many others that are on the platform. Also, if you are interested in other Framer features, let me know below what would you like me to cover next. Until then, subscribe, like, the usual YouTube stuff, and I'll see you soon.